My name is Robert Hasegawa. I'm a composer based here in Montreal, and I teach music theory and analysis at McGill, which is where I first met both Mayu and Sahara. I moved to Montreal in 2012 and was really interested by what I saw up here. There was this clear new music community that was very rich. I think the linguistic diversity of Montreal makes it really unique. I went to a tiny college that had just a music program, and most of my study was with one professor who was teaching me composition, music history, and music theory, and conducting the little orchestra we had there. Larry Wallach was his name. Getting into composing was a really exciting place to be. I really liked the aspect of thinking about music, of inventing melodies, so sort of creating something from nothing, as composers do. You have an idea, and all of a sudden it can become concrete, and then you can pass it to other people. So that was kind of a revelation to me, coming pretty late, I think, as a college student. I grew up in upstate New York. I'm fourth generation of mixed race. My father's family, which is all of Japanese descent, but my mother's family has Jewish immigrants coming in around the same time. My father's grandparents were the ones that came over from Japan, so his parents were born in the U.S. Part of the experience for me of being fourth generation is really being quite distinct, quite separate from those Japanese roots. There's not that much language left in my family. I always listened to a lot of rock and indie rock and punk growing up. Those were interesting to me. Contemporary composers, I think of the Spectral School, Gerard Griset. More recently, I've been really interested in the music of Rebecca Saunders, who does these amazing things with timbre, with orchestration. It's Pascal Criton, who I've been able to meet in Paris a few times while visiting there, and she writes this amazing microtonal music. Much of it is drone-based, sometimes using things like tiny, tiny intervals of 1/16th of a tone, if you can imagine that. These tiny things that give this very lively, very unstable kind of musical universe. The impetus for the piece really came out of this invitation from the duo to write for them, and then I was thinking a lot about the instrumentation of the piece. Two instruments I really love, the cello and piano, and thinking about the ways that they would interact with each other. And what I found I was thinking of most of all were these melodic concepts. It was all about melody, and a lot of the complexity of the piece, I think, develops out of really repeating and sharing and recomposing these little melodic fragments. Variation is so central to this piece, how it could build these complex forms, how the same idea might be sort of initiating in one moment, and then an idea that closes off a phrase somewhere else. So there's repetition, but the roles of the music change in each moment. I think of it as being very much like Bartok's music, this kind of Bartok parlando effect, where it's almost like a folk song. It's very much a kind of spoken rhythm. It's not in a regular meter. There's a part where the pianist has these very violent chords, which has a little bit of Rite of Spring in it, I think. There's a little bit of Stravinsky in that sound. The title of the piece arrived pretty late in the process. I decided to bring in the word Kogarashi, which was already the name of the duo. The name Kogarashi means winter wind. For a long time, especially when I was a kid, I really thought that my Asian identity, that side of my family, didn't mean all that much at all. I grew up in a very, very white, very rural environment, and there was very little sense of a belonging to a larger community. I think today is that complexity of backgrounds that so many of us have, like these multiply hyphenated names in some sense. So I'm fascinated by these issues of identity. I think we are negotiating things in different ways now than we were 30 or 40 years ago. I think some of it has to do with outside perception as much as our own internal reckoning in relationship to those cultures, that we are still seen as being, in some sense, from somewhere else. Thank you.
quietly held my breath and hoped that everyone would notice. Neon crowded with each other, making earthquakes with the crowds passing by. It seems that everything is never a transparent line, an anxious thing, but it made me feel like I shouldn't bring this tranquility. We overtook the adolescent, and one said so and started laughing, and everyone looked at him. When you live in the city, that kind of thing is common. I think it's all the work of light, sound, and acceleration of the city. In the meantime, we're rock stars without a guitar, a country that's present, a rock of those astronauts.
My name is Joel Toews, and I am a contemporary Canadian composer originally from Edmonton, Alberta, but I now live and work in Toronto, Ontario. The style of music that I like to write is, you know, blends the lines between classical and jazz and film scoring. I really took a lot of influence from cello sonatas of Rachmaninoff as well as Debussy. So my piece is a suite for piano and cello, and this suite is inspired by a culmination of elements that come from both Canada and Japan. So the first movement of my piece is called Maple Leaves and Cherry Blossoms. I wanted to take inspiration from the two most recognizable trees of each country, of Canada and Japan, with the maple tree and the cherry blossom tree. And I wanted a melody that was complex and inviting and beautiful and yet also haunting. The melody of this piece is meant to convey both the beauty of these trees as well as kind of like, you know, the drama of them losing their leaves as well as blooming in the springtime. And so you have this beautiful melody at the beginning that is carried by the cello and then mimicked by the piano. And then there's a sense of pause that comes in the middle, which I feel was inspired by the fact that these trees have such seasonal elements to them, where there is growth and then there is beauty and then there is also, you know, death followed by a dormant season, which is then repeated year after year. And that's the beauty and that is the story of both of these trees. So my second movement is called Metro Commute, and I already had this idea for a nature-inspired piece, so I wanted something that was more city-inspired. And, you know, I wanted something that can convey just the busyness, the hustle and bustle of Tokyo and Toronto or Montreal or Vancouver. The chime for the Metro subway station in Toronto, the TTC, is a descending major triad from 5 to 3 to 1, and that's it. So actually the opening of Metro Commute starts with that 5-3-1. I came across a composer named Minoru Megayu, and he composed all these short little jingles for the different train stations in Tokyo. And so I chose one from Shibuya Station, and that the melody of Shibuya Station is interwoven with the rhythmic pattern that is supposed to be the train underneath, as well as the melody of the passenger with his headphones or his, you know, book open. Everything leads to the finale where you have, you know, these metro chimes playing off one another. You have the busyness of the rhythm and the piano and the cello as all of the passengers are just desperately trying to get to their final stop. My final movement in this piece is called Folklore, and the main concept for this piece was to take a folk melody from Japan and a folk melody from Canada and interwove these two melodies. The piece starts with a melody from Japan called Tenkobushi, and this piece is traditionally a little bit faster and almost more dance-like than how I have written it. And the song Feller from Fortune, which is a traditional song from Newfoundland, it takes over in the cello. And all of a sudden you have this very dance, almost Celtic-esque melody that plays back and forth between the piano and the cello. It's a really cool feeling to feel like, you know, the Canadian music industry is interested in new classical music and is interested in a project like this that is going to really bring all of those different facets of Canadian arts together. And I think that it provides a really cool opportunity to show that Canada can be on the forefront of new music that is exciting and new music for everyone to listen to.
街を横切った時、僕らは確かに何かの始まりを感じていた。それが何なのかは僕には分からず、言葉にすることもできなかった。ただそっと息を潜め、みんなと目を合わせて、うなずくばかりだ。華やかさを競うように向き合うネオンも、行き交う群衆も、全部が透明な嘘のフィルター越しにあるみたいで、不安で叫び出したくなるような。 でもこの静けさを破ってはいけないような、そんな気持ちでさせられた。僕らが大人たちを追い越したのさ。一人がそう言って笑い出して、みんな彼の方を見た。この街で生きていると、そういう瞬間が訪れるものさ。多分全部光と音と若さゆえの加速度の仕業だと思う。その間僕らは北を持たないロックスターで、 国を持たない大統領で、ロケットを持たない宇宙飛行士で、とにかく無敵の存在なんだ。そして今夜だけ僕らは誰にも知れずに永遠の命を手に入れるのさ。
Thank you.